like you have in your physical body to protect it. Through a, you know, associate, you give them legal right into your world, basically. And when you get back into your body, you suddenly feel something's attached to you, or a presence in your body somewhere. Yeah, you don't want this. Doesn't make you. Demonic possession isn't always going insane, speaking demonic voices, or you eat spiders. Okay, the demon gets woven into your flesh, and its eyes become your eyes. But there, you know. It's only detectable because you feel off. There's something quite not right. You know this. So please be careful. And again, here we go. Mr. Aleister Crowley's back. It was an essential practice of any satanic magician, including Aleister Crowley. He referred to himself as the Beast 666 and once said, "I was not content to just believe in Satan. I wanted to be his chief of staff." There you go, okay. In chapter 13 of his Magic and Theory and Practice, he describes the beginning stages of soul travel. The first thing to do is to get the body outside your own. To avoid muddling the two, you begin by imagining a shape resembling yourself standing in front of you. Your own body has its eyes shut. One passes through the veil of the exterior world, called the body of light. This one develops and controls and gains new powers as one progresses. In the spiritual organization, Crowley started the AA. Mastering the astral plane was one of the requirements for graduating. There you go. Astral projection was taught and encouraged by him as being something absolutely essential to the ascension process. You can even go there and create your own satanic temples for magical purposes. Yeah, apparently he did. A satanic astral temple is a place where you can follow magic rituals in any form you want, even when the physical conditions are not ritual friendly. There's, of course, tons of demonic activity that goes on in the astral planes. Just, you know, you can't argue this. And there's apparently a whole bunch of different astral realms. And they call this, you know, the demonic parts and everything, the lower realms. Most experiences can be pleasant. And it could be quite beautiful. So just know what you're doing. Don't go into this blind. Just like, I'm going to do this, and then something's going bad's going to happen. Okay. You can be deceived by them. It's not a realm of sunshine and gumdrops, and it's not a magical realm where you can sail endlessly through the universe. This is a realm inhabited by demons, and demons disguised as beings of light. They seek to confuse, deceive, and destroy you. They want you to have false ideas about the astral realm. They do fear God and Jesus. excuse me. Even the Apostle Paul knew that the astral realm was the wrong neck of the woods to be in. He called Satan the ruler of the kingdom of air. Demons do their work from the spirit realm, of course. Just because you can astral project doesn't mean you should or it's safe. So please, please, please do your homework before you do this, okay? This isn't, you know, Game of Twister or anything like that. So don't be playing with this stuff. And again, one of the best movies, I think, that got us back interested in this. Was Insidious. I think that was the best. What's the word I want to use? Description. and how they showed it could is very true, okay? Insidious, I think that was a, if you're going to, you know, think about this, watch Insidious first, okay? Insidious Chapter 2, of course. Another astral projection movie is Psychic Killer. The Blue Man. And let's see, 10 of the best films. Doctor Strange. Insidious, of course. I think that is the best idea of astral projection ever. I really, and I think that renewed a big interest in it. Three, Dreams Come True. It's a 1984 movie. Psychic Killer, as I said. 75. It's one of the first films to show astral projection. It's hard. It isn't easy to find online, but it's a great film to watch. Awake is another one. If I Stay, it's a 80s flick. Out of the Body. Inception, of course, is a good one. Inception. This is about lucid dreaming, though, not astral projection, but it's still on the list because they're so closely linked. Of course, Leonardo DiCaprio is in it, Inception. It's a good movie. I have seen it. Please, if you... it's a great movie. See it if you can. High Plains Drifter, believe it or not. It's a loner type warrior from the astral realm, in case you didn't know. With, of course, Clint Eastwood. Altered States is another movie. So those are some movies that are good to about astral projection. So those are some things you can do. I've given you some books to look up, but please just don't, you know, go and do this, okay? I'm going to take a break here. Let's see. Does Insidious, accurately depict astral projection? And this was an article by and I can't find his name. And he wrote all about astroplanes and stuff. I hadn't seen the movie. He expected it to be totally inaccurate. Yeah, Altered States was a good flick. Yes, yes. Inception. If you haven't seen Inception, give it a try. It's worth a watch. This guy, Insidious, came up in cable, and he of course, watched it later. And was full of, he expected this, he assumed it was going to be full of inaccuracy and just total crap, right? The truth of it is they got it right, okay? And they immediately watch Insidious 2 the next day. And interesting correlations to reality. So, so he, this writer, agreed that, yes, there's a lot of good stuff in there. So, there you go. See Insidious. That, I think that's the best movie to see for that. I really do. I think they did it very, very well done with that. And it depicts the darker side of soul traveling, so to speak. So, give it a watch. Okay, we're going to take a quick break, and I'll be back. We're going to talk about some about falling dreams, so don't go away. Thank you.
Sometimes there's a moment as you're waking and you become aware of the real world around you, but you're still dreaming.